give you an example of how I might size an AC unit that can handle both the heating loads as well as the dehumidification loads. So let's say you have an indoor grow that is 5,000 square feet, full canopy, let's just say it's in veg, and you have one lamp for every 5x5 area. So you have 200 lamps in this space, and you have enough plants that you feed it 10 gallons of water per day. Okay, so here's what happens, is most of the time, a contractor will say, oh, you have this much heat coming from the lamp. So let's just keep it simple, and you have 1,000 watt high pressure sodium lamps. You have 200 of them. Okay, so that's 200,000 watts. I'm gonna convert that to BTUs, okay, BTUs per hour. And so I multiply by 3.2, and I come up with about 600,000 BTUs per hour. Then what I'm going to do, because air conditioning units are size based on tons, so I convert that to tons, and I get right around 54 tons of cooling. But you don't stop there. That's where the mistake commonly happens, is that they just look at how much load came from the lamps. But now I have to think about, well, how big do I need my cooling coils to be to also handle the amount of moisture that the plants are pumping into that space. So let's say you're pumping in 10 gallons of water every day to feed the plants. Now what I do is I can actually convert those gallons also into BTUs per hour that my cooling coil will see. And so what that comes out to for this particular operation is about 7 or 8 tons of additional cooling. Now, instead of an undersized system sized at 54 tons, now I know that my system needs to be sized actually for 61 or 62 tons of cooling so that it can remove moisture and cool the space. What I do that goes even beyond that is I would look at your structure, right? I would say, are you in a basement? Okay, there's not gonna be any heat transfer across the walls. Are you in a warehouse that's uninsulated? I might have a lot of heat transfer across the walls. Are you in a greenhouse? Oh my gosh, that's even more heat transfer across the walls. So I might add even some more heat gain for that. And let's just say, I don't know, it's 5 tons of extra cooling. So now I've gone from 54 tons to 65 or 66 tons of cooling because I actually size that system based on the true loads in that room. So now what I would recommend to you is, okay, now you need an HVAC unit that's sized for 70 tons of cooling. Or what we could do is we could size your HVAC unit for 60 tons of cooling and then put in a dehumidification unit that is sized for the 5 or 6 tons of dehumidification. But that's wrong too, because your dehumidification unit, in most cases, if it's in room, it pumps out heat. Right, have you ever stood next to your dehumidification unit as it's running and it's hot? And the reason it's hot is because it's converting that moisture into heat. And how much heat is it generating in the room? That same 5 or 6 tons that the cooling coil on that HVAC unit would have seen without that dehumidification unit. So now again, I have to bump up the size of that HVAC unit by 5 or 6 tons to deal with that extra heat from the dehumidification unit. So we could actually do all that work in one unit and eliminate that dehumidifier if you were able to size that unit right the first time.